Sesame Street, show number 36 in color.
Get to Sesame Street.
Sesame Street? Well, you go. You're on Sesame Street. This is it. Yeah.
So this is a place everybody's talking about.
Good move. Hi, gang.
Sesame Street looks like a real lively place. Looks like a good place to set up my hot dog stand. Think I'll set it up right over there by that stoop.
Good morning, everybody. Hi there, how are you?
Say, is that a person? I've never seen a person like that before. Wonder what sort of people live on Sesame Street. Well, I guess I'll find out soon enough. I'll just go get my hot dog stand and put it up on Sesame Street.
This is Chris. He has a pair of magic glasses. When Chris hears a noise, he puts his magic glasses on.
Thank you.
you can make these noises. Now your turn. Beep, beep. Ring.
Ten little Greeblies clinging to a vine. One chased a fly, and then there were nine. Nine little Greeblies riding on a skate. One tried a trick, and then there were eight. Eight little Greeblies zooming up to heaven. One took a shortcut. Then there were seven. Seven little Greeblies floating on some sticks. One started fishing. Then there were six. Six little Greeblies staring at a hive. One took some honey, and then there were five. Five little Greeblies rolling on the floor. One bugged a mouse. Then there were four. Four little Greeblies swimming in the sea. One forgot how. Then there were three. Three little Greeblies dancing round a shoe. One jumped in. And then there were two. Two little Greeblies sitting on a bun. One stayed too long. Then there was one. One little Greebly, missing all his brothers, wished upon a star, and then there were others.
Why? Yo-yo. Why?
Sodas, hot dogs, hot peanuts.
Oh, well, hello.
How do you do?
Gee, something sure smells good here.
Sodas, hot dogs, hot peanuts, what'll you have?
What'll we have? Hey, we'll have some peanuts. Gee, that's nice of you.
There's a bag of peanuts.
Oh, yeah, okay, here, kids, let's share them. While we're at it, maybe we can have some, hot dogs. Want a couple of hot dogs, kids?
Two hot dogs.
Sure.
Onion or sauerkraut?
Plain.
Plain, there you go. There's one, and here's the other one. There you are.
Gee, could we have some of this soda pop, too?
Well, it's your money.
Money? Money?
Yeah. So far, you owe me 60 cents.
Money? I didn't know it cost money.
What'd you think it cost?
Well, I thought it was free. You said, what'll you have? And I thought we were having a party.
A party? Oh, boy.
I'm sorry,
Mr. Glopper.
Mr. Glopper, I'm sorry. I've never seen anybody like you on Sesame Street before.
I've never seen anybody like you anywhere.
Well, I'm awfully sorry, but I don't have any money.
And you still owe me 60 cents.
L-Lunchbox.
L.
Hello there. I'd like you to meet my friend, the letter L. Recognize it? L is very useful, and so are things beginning with an L. Here's one. A ladder. A ladder is very useful when you want to climb up to a high place, like this. Hey. That was easy. Hey, come back here. I need that. Hey.
A ladder is also a useful thing to get down from a high place.
This is Mark. He has a pair of magic glasses. When Mark hears a noise, he puts his magic glasses on. See if you can make these noises. Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a, ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a. Now it's your turn. Ruff, ruff! Clippity-clock. Ding-ding.
I'll be back in just a minute, because I gotta throw this trash into the trash can, okay? Because you mustn't throw trash on the street. You have to throw trash into the trash can, like this.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Well, what do you mean, what I think I'm doing? I think I'm throwing trash into the trash can.
Not in this trash can, you nut.
And tell me exactly why not.
Because this is my house, my residence, and into my residence, nobody dumps anything that I don't want. Hey, and another thing, pipe down about your hot dogs and your stupid peanuts and soda pop. You're making too much noise. People live here. This is a residential area.
People live here, he says. The first thing I find when I come to Sesame Street is a big yellow bird that thinks everything is free. And then the next thing, this orange thing jumps out of a trash can and yells at me. Oh, boy. I'm afraid to look around here. I don't know what I'm going to see next.
Hey. Hey, Ernie. Hey, wake up, you meatball. You're supposed to be learning something.
Oh, well, I am. Sure.
Oh, yeah?
Sure.
Okay, then. Tell me, what is this?
Oh, that.
Yeah.
Let me think a minute.
Okay.
That is a chocolate cream pie.
No.
No?
No.
Well, let's see. Give me a hint.
Okay, watch this.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Find a toy.
One, two, three, four.
Four arms.
One, two, three, four.
Four root beer floats.
Now, Ernie, do you know what this is now?
Yeah, of course I do. That is a banana cream pie.
If this four is a banana cream pie,
yeah,
then what is this?
Huh, that's a four. Yeah, I knew what it was all along, but who wants to get hit in the face with a four?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Four.
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 Okay, listen, I have this letter here. Can you tell me what it is?
Why?
Right. And let's see, you understand about the shape
name?
Of it? Your name? What?
It ends with a Y.
It does.
And the end.
Well, you see what the shape of the Y is? How it has three, one here and one here and one here. Three little parts all sticking out from it. And these two are up on top, and this one holds them both.
It's like a V with the tail.
Yeah. Well, now let's
see. If you cut the tail off, it's a V.
Yeah, that's true. Well, listen, I drew some pictures, and I want you to look for this Y in those pictures, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Here.
That's right. There's a Y in the tree. Hmm. How can you tell? Because that's two lines there and one down here. There's another one in this drawing, I think.
There is?
Yeah, there are two in this drawing.
Here.
Path. That's right. And it's got the same thing, the two little lines up here and the
one
down
here. But
that
one's a bigger.
Yeah, bigger Y.
This.
What is that? Do you know what this is?
Nope. Oh,
the doctors use them.
That's right. It's called a stethoscope. And they listen through this, and they put these in their ear.
They listen to your heart.
Right.
There's nothing else.
And you didn't. I bet you never knew that was a Y before. I bet you never noticed that.
A zipper.
Right, you can't miss that. I bet you it wouldn't be a Y, though, if you zipped it all the way down.
It wouldn't.
No, then it would be something else.
It would look like a V.
Right. No, I think it would probably look like, I don't know, two ones, maybe, or something. I don't know. Anyway, we have a turkey.
Here.
Yeah. Right, the carving fork. I don't think there are any other Ys in there.
There's no more.
Right. Nobody's eaten that turkey yet.
No.
Here. About this?
Oh.
Yeah. Well, yes, wait a minute. We have to turn this boy upside down to see the Y. There we go.
But the Y has two arms.
The Y has two arms.
Y. Yo-yo. Whoa! Why?
Hi, Mr. Tooper.
Hooper. How are you, Big Bird?
Oh, not too good. I need a job. You see, I didn't know the hot dogs cost money. Mr. Glopper.
Mr. Glopper?
The man who sells the hot dogs. He did.
Hot dogs? Where?
Well, right down there.
You need a job. Everybody stops there and never comes to my store. We'll both need a job.
Well, I stopped there, and the sauerkraut did smell delicious.
He's got sauerkraut?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going in to telephone.
I'm going to order sauerkraut right away.
But Mr. Tooper, haven't you got a job that would pay me 60 cents?
I can't afford any help now, Big Bird. And if I don't make this telephone call, I'm liable to be out of business.
Oh, I sure wish I could find a job someplace.
Hey, Big Bird. Big Bird, come here.
Huh?
Hey, there's a terrific snake down in the pet shop window. Take a look at it.
Well,
I... Hey, isn't he a beauty? Look at him. It's a big boa constrictor. Do you like it?
Oh, no, I don't worry about snakes when I've got all the trouble that I've got.
Oh, what's your problem, Big Bird? You really look unhappy today.
Well, I am, Bob. You see, I was coming down the street.
Right.
Well, this fella had all these hot dogs, see?
What fella?
His name is Mr. Glopper.
Oh, right.
So he said, "What'll you have?" Well, I thought he was going to offer us like a party. So the kids there, and so we took some hot dogs and peanuts.
Right.
And then he said he wanted some money. And I didn't know he wanted money, Bob. So now I owe him 60 cents.
Now you owe him 60 cents
for all
the food.
And I need a job. I don't have 60 cents.
You know what happened, Big Bird? You had a misunderstanding because, well, you had a different point of view.
What?
A different point of view.
What's a point of view?
Well, you see, it's sort of like this. If you're a Big Bird, right? And you're looking down at things. So you see things from way up here.
Yeah.
But if you were... Oh, this snake, or if you were a little small person that was, say, this big, and you looked up at everything like that, you'd see the whole world and everything from a different point of view. One looking down and one looking up. That's a different point of view.
Oh! Hey, wait. What does this have to do with me owing Mr. Glopper 60 cents?
Well, it's the same thing as the hot dog thing, you see. Now, look, you came down the street and you saw Mr. Glopper with all his hot dogs and you said, "Oh, boy, he's having a big party," right?
Yeah.
And you thought everything was free.
Well, he said, "What'll you have?"
Sure.
That sounds like he's giving them away.
But Mr. Glopper down there, he's been selling hot dogs for years and years and years. And he saw you coming down the street with all the kids and he said, "Oh, here's a really good customer. He's going to buy all my things. I'm going to make a lot of money," right?
I guess he did, because he wants 60 cents.
Right. So you were both looking at the hot dogs and everything. You're both looking at the same thing. But you saw it one way, and Mr. Glopper, he saw it a different way.
Yeah.
Now that's a different point of view. So you had a problem there.
I think I understand.
Do you understand it now?
A little more.
It's about the same thing as, you know, the little boy or the snake looking at things, and you, because you're so different.
See, that snake would see things different. Look how... He wouldn't stand very tall, would he?
If he could stand, Big Bird, he'd stand about up to here. But some of these... Some of these snakes would be twice as long as you. If they could stand on their tail, they'd be twice as tall as you, Big Bird.
That's a big snake.
This is called a boa constrictor.
Oh, they don't come from around here, do they?
No, mostly in very warm places, like jungles and places where it's kind of hot and moist like that.
Uh-huh.
He's kind of all wrapped up around here. And...
Is he slimy?
No, he's not. A lot of people think that snakes are slimy, but they're not really. They're very dry.
He looks pretty.
He's beautiful. Nice spots all over and everything.
He has nice skin. It looks like plastic.
Yeah, it's not, though. It's very dry. It's kind of scales.
What kind of an animal is he? I mean, a snake, but...
A snake is a...
He's not a bird.
No, he's not a bird. Fish. Can you think what he is?
He's not a toad.
Nope, he's not a toad. He's a reptile. You call snakes or reptiles, Big Bird?
Well, right now, I wouldn't mind being him.
Why?
Because he doesn't owe Mr. Glopper 60 cents.
No, he certainly doesn't. Hey, you know, speaking about numbers, Big Bird, I have a very, very important message from the number 5.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5, 5, 5, 5.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
five. Whatever they are.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five frogs.
One, two, three, four, five.
Five guys.
One, two, three, four, five.
Hey, Mr. Hooper, how about three nice chocolate sodas for Shelley and a really big one for Big Bird, because mm-hmm. he's really down in the dumps today, you know,
Bob, with this problem he's got. Bob, I'm very busy now, huh? Can you wait a few moments?
Just three chocolate sodas.
I'm having
sodas.
Very Wouldn't important for... sale of hot dogs and sauerkraut, and I have to get out these announcements, so you'll excuse me.
Okay.
Big Bird?
Yeah?
Look through the door and see how many customers Mr. Glopper has, huh?
Okay, Mr. Tooper. Let's see. Okay. Hi, I'm back. He has only one.
Oh, and last time I looked through the door, he had three.
Uh-huh.
That's less than three. One is less than three.
That's right.
That's good. Now, Big Bird.
Yes.
I'm going to give everybody more for their money than Mr. Glopper gives. For their money, in terms of the hot dogs, bags of nuts, and soda. So, Big Bird, tell me, how many hot dogs does Mr. Glopper give for a quarter?
Let me see. One.
One?
One, right?
One hot dog.
One hot dog for a quarter. I'm going to give more than one. I'm going to give two hot dogs for a quarter. And how many bags of nuts does Mr. Glopper give for a dime?
One.
One?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get more than one. I'm going to get two bags of nuts for
great.
A dime, huh? And now, how many bottles of soda does Mr. Glopper give for a dime?
One.
One. I'm going to get... No, I'll give the same. I'll give one bottle of soda for a dime. I can't give away too much. I can go broke, you know, huh?
Yes. Hey, Mr. Hooper,
yes.
When will you get around to making our chocolate sodas? Really
in a few minutes, huh?
Have I got time to read this book?
Sure.
I make them? Okay,
thank
good.
You.
Hey, listen, Shelley, would you like to hear this book? It's called I'll Fix Anthony. And you know what it's about? It's about a little boy that has a big brother, and he teases his little brother all the time. His big brother's called Anthony. And they kind of have a different point of view, just like Big Bird and I were talking about earlier. Now, he says a lot of things to his little brother, and I don't think he really means them all the time, but can you see? He says, my brother Anthony can read books now, but he won't read any books to me. He plays checkers with Bruce from his school, but when I want to play, he says, go away or I'll clobber you. I let him wear my Snoopy sweatshirt, but he never lets me borrow his sword. Mother says, deep down in his heart, Anthony really loves me. Anthony says, deep down in his heart, he thinks I stink. Mother says, deep, deep down in his heart, where he doesn't even know it himself, Anthony loves me. Anthony says, deep, deep down in his heart, he still thinks I stink. When I'm six, I'll fix Anthony. When I'm six, a dog will follow me home, and she'll beg for me, and I'll roll over, and she'll lick my face. If Anthony tries to pet her, she'll give him a bite. When I'm six, Anthony will have the German measles, and my father will take me to a baseball game. And then Anthony will have the mumps, and my mother will take me to the flower show. Then Anthony will have a virus, and my grandfather will take me to the movies. I won't have to save popcorn for Anthony, unless I want to. When I'm six, I'll be tall, and Anthony will be short, because I'll eat things like carrots and potatoes, and he'll eat things like jelly beans and root beer. I'll put his red sneakers on the top shelf, and if he stands on a chair, he still won't be able to reach them. He'll tell me, get down my sneakers, and I'll say, say please. And if he doesn't say please, he can't have his sneakers for 100 years. When I'm 6, I'll add 7 and 4 and 10 and 3 inside my mind. And Anthony will just add 1 and 1 and 2, and he'll have to use his fingers. When I'm 6, we'll have a race. And I'll be at the corner when Anthony hasn't even passed the fire plug. The next time I'll give him a head start, but it won't help. When I'm 6, friends will call me on the telephone, and no one will call Anthony. I'll sleep at Charlie's house, Nettie's, and Diana's, but Anthony will always sleep at home. See you later, Anthony, I'll tell him. When I'm 6, I'll help people carry their groceries from the supermarket, and they'll say, my, you're strong. I don't think Anthony will be strong enough. When I'm 6, I'll be able to tell left and right, but Anthony will be all mixed up. I'll be able to tell time, but Anthony will be all mixed up. I'll be able to tell my street and my city and sometimes my zip code, but Anthony will be all mixed up. If he ever gets lost, I guess I'll have to go find him. When I'm 6, I'll go, bingo, all the time. Anthony won't even go bingo once. I'll win all the tic-tac-toes if I'm X. And I'll win them all if I'm O. Too bad, Anthony, I'll say. Oh, Anthony's chasing me out of the playroom. He says I stink. He says he's gonna clobber me. I have to run now, but I won't have to run when I'm 6. When I'm 6, I'll fix Anthony. Did you like that story? Did you ever feel like you want to get even with somebody like that when you get bigger?
Big Bird, do you still want that job?
Oh, boy, do I.
All right. Here, take these announcements and give them to everybody you see, and when you're through with that, come back, and I'll pay you 60 cents.
Wow, I'll sure do that. I'll be right back, Mr. Looper.
Hoopa, Big Bird, hoopa.
Good luck, Bird.
Oh, hi. Hey, Jenny.
Hey,
Brian.
Yeah. Oh,
hey.
Hi.
Hey, I got a job, and I'm handing out flyers for Mr. Hooper. Here, it's all about a big sale.
Oh,
read about that. Boy, oh, Susan.
Yes,
Susan,
yes.
Look at this. A big sale at Mr. Hooper's.
Oh, really? Thank you, Big Bird.
Oh, I wonder who else I could give one to. I'll give one to Mr. Glopper. Here.
It's you again.
Mr. Glopper, you might as well have... it's about a big sale here that Mr. Hooper's having.
2 hot dogs for the price of 1 at Mr. Hooper's.
Yeah, he's having a sale.
What is it with you? You're always trying to make trouble for me.
Huh?
You're trying to drive me out of business?
Well, no, I'm not trying to make trouble, but...
Hey, listen, Mr. Glopper, excuse me for interrupting, okay? But Big Bird and I have been friends for a long, long time here on Sesame Street. Right, Big Bird?
Yeah.
And believe me, he is not trying to cheat you or do you any harm.
There has just been
a misunderstanding between you and Big Bird about these hot dogs.
Right.
I tell you one thing, mister. I've never seen a place like this here, Sesame Street. The first thing when I get here this morning, the Big Bird walks up and he thinks that everything I got is free. And then a thing jumps out of the trash can and yells right in my face. I tell you, you never know what's gonna happen next around here.
Thank you.
broken.
Done. It's done. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Yeah?
Come on. Hey, Bert, it's done.
Well, what's done?
The story I just wrote.
Story?
Greatest story in the whole wide world.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, let me read it to you.
Well, is it going to take long?
Oh, no, it's just a short story, Bert.
All right, read it to me.
Okay, you're going to love this story. It's greatest story in the world.
Yeah, just read it to me, Ernie.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Here it comes. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now comes the sad part. H I J K
Ernie
L M N O
Ernie
B. Here, now listen to this. This is the action part that starts now.
Yeah.
Q R S T
Ernie, that's the alphabet.
Oh, but listen to the wind up. V W X Y. Well, what?
Well, finish it. Go ahead. You went U, V, W, X, Y, and you stopped there. Go ahead, finish it.
What? And tell you how the story ends? Then you'll never want to read it.
Why? Yo-yo. Whoa, 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 why?
Is that supposed to be? All right, well, let's see what fine detectives you two are, okay? I'm going to show you some pictures.
And we got to see what...
And then you tell me what happened before I drew the picture, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Here's the first one.
The
fire came through.
Yeah, the fire came. And then what happened, though? Something else happened.
The girl jumped out.
Where'd she jump from? From the building?
Yeah.
That's right. And the firemen all hold this net to catch her with. She also has a little pussycat in her lap, too.
I know. She didn't want the pussycat to die.
That's right. Okay.
The mailman came in first.
Came to the door first.
Yeah.
Right.
And gave her the letter first.
Then gave the letter to her, and then she opened it. And then he walked away.
Right, and she's reading her letter that she got from... He carries his mail in this little pouch here, I think.
I know. I'm right, too.
That's right,
you're both right. Okay, let's see the next one. How about this
he
one?
He got the book he went into the library.
Wait.
First he went in the library.
Yeah, and then what happened?
Then he came out with some books.
Well, do you know how he did that?
He walked.
Well, now he has to have a card, too.
Yeah.
Because then he has to return the books when he's through reading them.
Right. Now I do the next one.
Okay. The next one Mauricio does. Okay.
Is it coming or going?
It's going.
Away?
It's going away, yes. He's about to shut this door right here to the bus.
He stopped first, and then he went. Then he stopped.
When he stopped, and did they? You think they got off?
Yes.
And then the little boy's going to wave goodbye to the bus driver.
Yes.
Right?
Is that right?
Yeah, that's true. Oh.
What is he?
Oh, I think that's going to be our Skywriter friend. Yes,
hey,
it is.
It is. Looks like...
Oh, what do you think that's going to be?
Maybe an L.
Yeah?
No.
Well, maybe it's an I, too. Might be an I.
No, it looks backwards J.
No, maybe...
Well, I don't think he'd do it backwards.
A U?
Yeah, maybe a U.
Maybe
oh, it
a
may
D.
Be, yeah, it might be a D.
Yeah,
but it looks like more of a U to me.
Well, he's straightening out.
Yeah, it's a U.
Yep, it's a U.
Yeah. Just
looked
like
a salute to the letter U. Useful for words beginning with U, little words such as use. big words, such as university. And in between words, such as ukulele. Without the letter U, there would be no universe. Or uranium. Without the letter U, units would be...
nets?
Policemen would have no uniforms, and nothing would be useful. For instance, who ever heard of an I.O.? So here's to you, you. You've earned your place in the alphabet. And so to you, you. For your unique, universal usability, we say thank you, you.
Anybody want to buy a used U?
Oh, Mr. Glopper! Mr. Glopper?
Hiya, Big Bird. It's you again, huh?
Yeah, well, I have your 60 cents for you. Here. There. Now I don't owe you any money.
Wait a minute, Big Bird. Where did a big bird like you get 60 cents?
Well, I found a job so I could earn the money.
You mean you took a job so you could pay me back my 60 cents?
Oh, yes. Mr. Hooper hired me to hand out the papers for him, those flyers like the one I gave you, so that I could earn 60 cents.
Wow. And all the time, I thought you was trying to drive me out of business.
Oh, no. I would never want to do that.
You know something, Big Bird?
Hmm?
We just had a misunderstanding between the two of us.
Yeah,
that's it.
That's right.
I tell you what, Big Bird. I'm going to take the 60 cents and divide it in half. There's 30 cents for you and 30 cents for me, just because it was really a misunderstanding between us two people.
Yeah, well, we had different points of view. And now that I've got 30 cents back,
yeah,
I'm going to give it back to you because I'd like to buy 3 bags of peanuts, please.
You're a good bird, Big Bird. There you are. 1, 2... 3 bags of peanuts for 30 cents.
Wowie-kazowie. Well, look at that.
You're an honest bird, Big Bird.
Oh, thank you very much.
Well, I see you.
But wait, where are you going?
Well, Big Bird, it's like this. I'm going to take my hot dog stand to another street.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you see, you don't really need me on Sesame Street.
We don't?
Because over there is Mr. Hooper's store. It's a nice store, and you know, right now everybody's inside, taking advantage of his wonderful sale that you helped him pull off. So
good.
You don't really need me on Sesame Street. But you know one thing, Big Bird?
What's that?
Come here. It's been nice meeting you, Big Bird.
Oh, well, thank you, Mr. Glopper.
Well, so long, Big Bird.
Bye.
Bye.
Gee, Mr. Glopper was really very nice. And I'm afraid I had things rather mixed up for a while. But I'll never get things as mixed up as Buddy and Jim can do it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hello, Jim.
Hello, Buddy.
How are you?
Fine. How are you today?
Good. You going somewhere?
Yes, Buddy. I thought I was going to go for a walk. Would you like to come?
Boy, would I like to go for a walk today, Jim.
Come on.
I feel like a good walk today.
Hold everything.
What is it, Jim?
Hold it.
What is it?
Look at your feet.
Yeah. What's the matter with them, Jim? I just washed them. As a matter of fact, I took a whole bath.
Buddy, that's not what I mean.
What?
I mean, look at your feet.
Yeah?
Didn't you just tell me you wanted to go for a walk with me?
Sure would like to, Jim.
Well, it's cold outside. You can't go out for a walk with your bare feet. Where are your shoes and socks?
Oh, they're right there where I left them.
Well, go over and put them on so we can go for a walk.
Oh, okay, Jim. Let's see. I really do feel like a walk. There's one shoe. And here's a sock. Pretty socks. And here's another shoe on this foot.
Hurry up, buddy.
Okay. Hey, Jim, where are we going on the walk?
I figured we'd go to the zoo today.
Oh, boy, maybe we'd see that big elephant again, huh?
If he's still there.
Yeah. Boy, he was bigger than a parakeet last time I saw him. All right, I'm ready to go for a walk to the zoo.
Let's go.
Good. Wait, whoa, something wrong, Jim.
What is it, buddy?
The socks are slippery. I almost fell down.
Buddy.
What?
Look what you've done. You put your shoes and socks on all wrong.
Wrong?
Of course you did.
You got a shoe and a sock and a shoe and a sock.
You're supposed to put the sock on first, and then you put the shoe on after you put your socks on. You did it all wrong.
Wow.
Now go back there and do it right.
All right.
Hurry up. It's getting late.
Here we go. Hey, Jim.
What is it?
Maybe we'll see one of the zebras today, huh?
We'll probably see two or three zebras, but you have to hurry up before the zoo closes.
Right. You know something, Jim? You know what zebras have?
What?
Zebras have stripes.
You didn't know any of that, did you?
All right, now I got a sock on, another sock, and now I got a shoe on this foot, and a shoe on that foot. Now, ready to go.
Let's go.
Hey, Jim.
What is it this time?
Ooh! My shoes are attacking me. They hurt my feet.
Wait a minute. There's something wrong here.
Yeah, something real bad wrong with my shoes, Jim.
Buddy.
Huh?
You've got your right foot where your left foot is supposed to be, and your left foot is where the right foot is supposed to be. That's why your feet hurt.
Is that why my feet hurt?
Of course that's the reason.
Whoa, what are we going to do now, Jim?
Very simple.
Simple?
All you have to do is cross one leg over the other, and then your feet will be right.
Really?
Of course. Very simple. It's right over there, and now the shoes are where they're supposed to be.
Boy, you sure are smart, Jim.
Let's go for our walk.
All right.
Ready now?
Yep.
Let's go.
Let's go. Not too fast, though.
Buddy.
What is it?
What's wrong?
Well, nothing's wrong. I just can't go a little too fast there. You walk, take too big steps for me, Jim.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
There's something wrong here.
What's wrong?
Buddy.
Uh-huh.
You've got your shoes on the wrong feet.
I've got my shoes on the wrong feet?
Certainly, you have your shoes on the wrong feet.
They're the only feet I got.
That's not what I mean. I mean that you have your left shoe where your right shoe is supposed to be, and your right shoe is where your left shoe is supposed to be.
Yeah? So what do I do now?
You've got to go over there and put the right shoes on the right feet.
Oh, okay.
Hurry up. This is the last time
we're going
to wait for you.
Right, don't go away. I'll be right with you. That's 75. I think I got it, Jim. I think I got it this time.
Put your right shoe on your right foot and your left shoe
on
your left
foot. On the left foot. Ta-da! There you are.
Ready to go.
I'm ready to go.
No, you're not.
What's the matter?
Look at your shoes.
What's the matter? What's wrong?
You forgot to tie your shoelaces.
Well, let that slip, didn't I, Jim? Well, I'll have it undone in no time.
Do you know how to tie a bow?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Tie a funny bow here. There. That's a nice bow.
Okay. Let's go.
Let's go.
Go to the zoo.
Hey, not too fast, though. Hey, Jim. I'm not walking fast enough. I just don't think I can fix my feet. Jim. Hey, Jim. Can you fix my feet?
Buddy, this time I don't think I can fix your feet.
Jim can't fix my feet?
Not this time, but I've got a better idea.
Good boy.
You come outside with me now,
yeah?
And I'm going to teach you something. You know what I'm going to teach you?
What?
I'm going to teach you how to walk on your hands.
You kidding?
Right outside, I'll teach you how to walk on your hands. Come on.
You're going to teach me how to walk on my hands? Oh, boy. I can hardly wait. Jim's gonna teach me how to walk on my hands. Oh, boy.
Ford, let me have another one of Big Bird's peanuts. It's pretty nice of Big Bird to leave some peanuts for the squirrel, particularly this gray squirrel. I'm gonna try to get him to eat a whole peanut. Gray squirrel? Hey. Hey, gray squirrel. Wake up. Wake up, it's time to eat. What do you think his problem is, Ford?
The shell's around.
The shell? Yeah, I had one down here without the shell on it, but he didn't want that either. I thought he dug shells, you know. Come on, gray squirrel. This is good, nutritious peanut. Get it. Oh, gray squirrel. Come on. Come on. What would George Washington Carver say if he turned down a peanut? Come on, gray squirrel. Don't you like it? You really don't? I don't think we ought to force him. Okay. You don't eat a peanut. You know, this squirrel's about 10 weeks old, right? Oh. But one thing to remember about squirrels is that all squirrels out there are not like this one. It's a different kind of squirrel in the sense that we know that he won't bite and we know that he is not rabid, he doesn't have rabies. But we don't know that about all the other squirrels, so we have to kind of cool it with them. So while he's sitting here relaxing, doing absolutely nothing, we're going to watch this message from the letter L.
L. Lunchbox. L.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Four.
Why? Yo-yo.
Jazzy Triangle, who just loved to dance. As you can see, a triangle has three sides. Triangle met a very square, who also loved to dance in his own way.
Oh, boy, are you square? You don't move. You're always the same. All four sides, the same length. One, two, three, four. All four corners square as a box. I have three sides, and I can make them as long or as short as I want. I can be tall and thin, or short and fat, depending on how I feel. I sure am glad I'm a triangle.
Well, it's true I can't dance as well as you can, and my sides and corners are always the same. But I don't have to decide which side to make long and which short. And I never have to think about what shape I want to be. I like being a square.
Yeah, but wouldn't you like to be able to move around as you please, like me, and change your shape any time you feel like it? Like this?
When you're a square, and that's that. Nothing personal. You like being a triangle. I like being a square. Everyone can't be the same. Well, so long. Nice talking to you. The triangle watched him go.
Not a bad guy,
he thought. for a square. And he danced all the way home.
Hey, did you see the squirrel? It left. It just hopped up and went up a tree someplace. The squirrel's gone. We've got to go, too. But you come back and join us as soon as you can. We'll be here on Sesame Street, okay? It's a promise.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters L, U, and Y, and by the numbers 4 and 5. I'll Fix Anthony was written by Judith Viorst. The pictures were drawn by Arnold Lobel, published by Harper & Row, copyright 1969. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.